He launches this one way up in the air, way back at the 22-yard line. Palmer on a reverse, gives the ball off. It's number 10, Tommy Jackson. He's over the 35-yard line. And they aren't bad. They're only giving up 86 yards a game on the ground. There's Brian Deal to kick it again. Kind of a wobbly spiral. It'll hit at the 24 and get a tremendous roll all the way down to the 1.5-yard line. Quick look, and this one is intercepted. George Teague has it. And he will be out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Ball was tipped by Derek Oden, the inside linebacker, and George Teague pulled down his second interception of the year, the 10th of his Alabama career. And Dotson, who had 3 against Arkansas, now has 7. Third and 20. Parker up top, end zone. Palmer, touchdown! David Palmer with his first receiving touchdown of the year. And Alabama leads it 6-0. Did you see that Virginia score? They better not be thinking about Florida State next week. Trailing William and Mary. Parker, nice touch. Palmer has it out at midfield. And flags again. Abdul Jackson. Yep. This is probably the smartest offensive line in the country.
Ball. Offside. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Results in a first down.
There's a little swing out to Palmer. Couldn't get inside. Fumble. And it looks like it was covered by an offensive linesman downfield. I think it was Matt Hammond, 63. On 2nd and 2. That was Chris Anderson feeling his way through. Anderson, a good, experienced backup to Derek Lassig at the tailback spot.
And they're going to always be positive in turnovers. Stopping the run, they're setting the SEC and running it.
On first down, this one right down the sidelines, Kevin Lee. First down at the 13, Parker to Lee. Cuts inside, he's down to the 5. Johnny Dixon knocked him down from behind. Third down and 2 at the 5. Single back set, there's Houston motioning. Anderson gets the pitch. Cuts it up inside the 3, down to the 2, and that will be a first down. First and goal from the 2. Houston and Lassig behind Parker. Lassig has it up, not over, so he walks into the end zone. The defense bounced him to the outside, and he took it in. Alabama leads 13-0. First down out at the 47.
Small down the sideline. He's got it, and he will score. Eddie Small took it right away from George Teague and high-stepped it into the end zone. A 53-yard touchdown play with a minute 26 to go before halftime.
Forget though, David Palmer standing back by his goal line for the ensuing kickoff. Brian Lee will kick it for the Rebels. And he will pooch it high in the air, far side, 8-yard line. And that is Chris Anderson. He breaks it near side, over the 30, out over the 35-yard line, a flag on the play.
You know he's going to lose to a good team Holy. Once in a while.
On the return team. Back up 10 yards, spot to fall. After the play was over, personal foul. White team, 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
First down for the Tide at the 37. They've got time, 2 timeouts remaining. Barker, far side, Chris Wembley, out of bounds at the 37.
I got talked into that. That wasn't the smart thing to do, but I did it, and now here he goes again. Those linemen love to go for it on fourth down.
Parker throwing. Ball might have been tipped. It's caught by Wimbley inside the 20. This will be a 28-yarder near the far hash by Michael Proctor. And the freshman out of Pelham, Alabama, has no problem with that one. He is now 14 of 21 this year. It was scoreless after one quarter of play. A Palmer touchdown, a Lassick touchdown, put Bama in control. But Eddie Small with a long touchdown pass from Russ Shouse got Ole Miss back in it with a minute 26 to go. And then driving it down and getting the field goal, Alabama now leads 17-7 at half. Tied by 10 at the half. They're trying to go 8-0, looking for 5-0 in the SEC with a win here today. Palmer is back at his one. He's got some room up to the 25. He'll be cracked down right at the 30-yard line. Parker has to run out. Left side. And the ball was caught out near the 40. Maybe close enough for a first down. Kevin Lee.
Kevin Lee makes the catch. It's a first down for Alabama.
Yeah, it was Amos gambling on the interception. On first down, Derek Lassick all the way out to midfield.
Four games over 100 yards. Second leading rusher in the SEC.
Nine on that carry. And they call on the fullback, Martin Houston, for the first down.
Worked very well together under the tutelage of Danny Pierman and Jimmy Fuller.
Palmer in motion. He went one way, then the other, got the deep pitch. And he'll get down over the 40-yard line. Great down at one. Houston just trying to barrel his way ahead. Artis Ford had his arms around him. And Martin Houston at 5'10", 235, the proverbial low center of gravity, was tough to bring down. On the first and 10, they let him come. Here's the screen. Anderson inside the 25, the 20, down to the 15-yard line. But Jay Parker has a new career high in pass completions with 15. He may want to wear that brace every week. He fakes, pumps it into the end zone, intercepted as Prince Wimbley stopped the pattern, and Dwayne Amos followed the ball into the deep reaches of the end zone. Amos with his first interception of the year. Chisholm will kick it. He's had a long of 51 today and a pretty good average. David Palmer, boy, he's dangerous when he's standing around midfield. Something could happen for Bama here. And look at the long kick by Chisholm. Palmer at his 35, trying to get outside. And he'll get almost up to midfield. I thought he was tackled, and all of a sudden he squirted loose again. He just can't get that last score he needs to really get a hold on this ball game. As long as it's a 10-point game, too close to call. Parker out to the right side. Nice grab by Kevin Lee. Ross, the only senior. Second and 12. Parker off to the left side, and that's Curtis Brown. Third and 6 for the Tide at the 34 of Ole Miss. Parker, who's having a big day, has to wait. He gets it, and that is Curtis Brown. He almost breaks it. Danny Boyd caught up with him. First and goal from the 8. It's Williams, the sophomore, inside the 5. Good yardage on first down for the Crimson Tide.
Defensively, make a play once in a while, but you figure they'll drop one.
Third and goal from the 1. It's Williams cutting up. Touchdown, Alabama. Sherman Williams, his 4th rushing touchdown of the year, and then makes it 23-7 with 13:28 to go. Almost half the field and 3:18 for the scoring drive. Proctor will let it go. And it is Joe Woods inside his 5. Check it, it's 41. That's Mark Smith. He's still on his feet. He's almost out to midfield and across midfield. Everybody was missing number 41.
Ole Miss 2 out of 9 on third down today. This is 3rd and 10. Launching one high in the air. And it looks like George Teague might have picked it off. We have a flag.
There was a cornerback running with the receiver. George Teague was in a safety position there, coming from the middle of the field, and went up, played the ball beautifully.
This will negate the interception. It'll go against Alabama. First down at the 32. Take to the fullback. Option play. And Russ Shouse, who had run the ball 39 times this year for minus 10 coming in, the man on the carry. Play action. Drilled out to the right side, and that ball is caught down around the 15-yard line on a great grab by Eddie Small. Well, they'll go for the field goal, a 32-yarder here. And it is stroked through nicely by Brian Lee. I guess Billy Brewer figuring, I need 3 scores. Let's get the sure 3, and then we'll hope for a couple of touchdowns later. Still a long way to go. And this could be a big play in the game. 3rd and 10 for Bama. They'll have to get it back to the Rebels if they don't convert. Parker with time. He's got a man, but it is short of the first down.
They've done an exceptional job of making the tackle and preventing any additional yardage from being gained.
Brian Deal with the kick. Wobbly spiral, won't hang up. He gets another great bounce. And now it'll be taken by Jermaine Kahn. There's a flag laying back at the 33-yard line of Alabama. Holding on the offensive team.
Wait a second now.
Holding on the line of scrimmage. 10-yard penalty, previous spot, results in a first down.
Well, they gave us the wrong team. Joe Parker with another chance. Left side. Ball is pulled down on a great catch. Number 37, Kevin Lee.
They run one for every point they give up.
Whoa.
They've got an incentive not to give up a lot of them.
Parker to Anderson. He cuts it out very close to first down yardage. 4th and 1. Parker keeps it. He's over the 20-yard line, which would move the chains, and Alabama will have at least 4 more downs.
You know, he put the ball on the ground, kick a field goal here, but he comes from the old school, and he feels like he has a chance to be there at the end. He may have Miami in the Sugar Bowl, and he'll have a shot then for the national championship.
This one twisting to the left and missing it was Michael Proctor from 35 yards out.
This defense has given a lot of people a tough day. Shouldn't feel alone about that.
Fumble. It's picked off by John Copeland. Right to him after the failed exchange. And that may snuff out any hopes Ole Miss has of winning today. Jay Barker with the biggest day by an Alabama quarterback in the last 3 years.
Working on that spitting a little bit.
Had only thrown
get that down if you want to be an All-American, Jay.
Had only thrown for 800 yards in 7 ball games. Third down and 11. Bergdorf rushed. Running up the middle. Down to the 10-yard line, and that's close to a first down. 4th and 1. Bergdorf keeps. And that rugby scrum looks good enough for a first down. We do have a flag, though. Offsides on Ole Miss. 1st and goal from the 4. Pitch to Williams, getting outside. He will score. Sherman Williams with his 2nd touchdown of the day. 3rd down and 5 for the Rebels, working out of the eye.
Adams with a little play action. He gets out there quickly, and he will scoot to the near side. He needed the 39-yard line for a first down, at least here in Tuscaloosa. There's a pitch to Duinis, and he's got the first down. He breaks it, and he might go, but he will be caught inside the 20, and it may have taken a face mask to get him. Third down and four. Look out. Here comes Lockett. And Victor Lockett sacks Lawrence Adams. He will wobble it out to the right side, and Eddie Small can't hold on. It was way short of first down yardage, and that'll do it with 9 seconds to go. Even keel head coach is Gene Stallings.
You bet. Don't brood about a defeat too long. Don't gloat over a victory.
Well, they can celebrate this one for a couple of weeks because they don't play again until November 7th. Alabama goes 8-0, their 18th consecutive win. You know, they've now won 25 out of 29 since that 0-3 start in 1990. They were all over the coach then. He's the folk hero now, and a big day for Jay Barker. It looks like a bear. In fact, Bama is back. They've been back for a while. They never really went away.
As Bama will take it, first and 10 from the 26-yard line. And they give it to the up-back right there, 35, Martin Houston. Second down. And Lassick, spinning, has got the first down across the 40 to the 43-yard line. Ivory Hilliard, number three, came up to make the tackle along with Ray Adams. So, of course, Curly Hallman, former head coach at Southern Mississippi, and Gene Stallings' first game as head coach at Alabama. Hallman came in and beat his former mentor and head coach at Texas A&M. Lassick with a big hole that time off the right side, inside the 45 to the 44-yard line. I mentioned Lassick has had a good last four games. He has rushed for 444 yards and five touchdowns in those last four games. As Palmer comes in motion and they give it to him around the right side, Palmer cuts it back toward the middle. He is dangerous every time he touches the football as he gets to the 30-yard line. Seventh play of the drive, second and seven. As they give it to Lassick, cuts it back toward the middle. He's got the first down as he's pushed to the 20-yard line. 29-yard attempt. He's 14 out of 22 so far this year. And it's good. So Proctor has tied it up with 7:27. Up to go, first quarter. In motion is Jacob to the far side. Pitch back, fumble. Alabama's going to get it.
18-yard drive for a touchdown. For
all
Alabama
at the 17-yard line as Barker will hand it off to Lassick. And Lassick gets down to the 10. Second down and three as Lassick will get it one more time. And Lassick down inside the 5 to the 4. Second and goal. Lassick the deep back. He gets it. Touchdown. His eighth rushing touchdown of the year. 6'6", 255-pounder on a third and eight. Howard to throw the football. And it was a complete, oh,
yes.
What a catch at the 39-yard line. And that's the first time he's been sacked over the last three games. And he's got pressure on him right now. He's able to elude it initially. He's got all sorts of room. He can get to the stakes and does. Beautiful job by Jamie Howard, the freshman from Lafayette, Louisiana. It's third and seven. He's going deep. Intercepted inside the 5-yard line. Number 10 back there, Tommy Johnson. You're right on that. Second and 10. Barker wants to throw it again. He's in trouble. He's sacked. He is sacked by James Gilliard in the safety. Gilliard's been very active so far. He's got five tackles in that sack. And when's the last time you had a 10-5 game? That's what it is here. Alabama 10-5. They'll get the free kick. Ryan Deal will set it down. And bobbled momentarily and then picked up by number three of LSU, Ivory Hillier, trips to the far side for LSU on third down and four. Howard pump fakes. Now he goes deep. He just throws it up in the air and another interception. Yes! Another pick, this time by number 13, George Teague, the senior from Montgomery, his fifth interception of the year and 11th of his career.
He came in, controlled that short passing game, didn't lose his composure.
Brian Deal, that's a short kick. Carlton Buckles will take it on the bounce at the 47. And Buckles gets about 3 yards. Third down and five. LSU 2 of 5 in third down situations. Howard eludes the pressure. He's got the first down, and he slides inside the 30. Third down and 11. Howard, lots of pressure. Can't elude it. And might have lost the football. At the 40-yard line, he did, and it's recovered by Frank Godfrey, the center. Back deep, David Palmer for Alabama. Brian DeSales standing back at his 46-yard line to punt it. It's a short end-over-end punt. Palmer, the fair catch at the 14-yard line. He was originally a defensive player, but then they moved him to running back because of injuries. Now he's back to where he's comfortable at. It's Barker on the middle screen to Palmer. And Palmer is wrapped up at the 32-yard line.
And then go for something a little bigger.
That was his first completion. He's 1 of 4 and make it 2 of 5 now as he finds Prince Wembley. Chris Anderson took the brunt of that, the ball carry on 3rd and 2. Pass completed to the near side. Prince Wembley makes the catch, and that's more than enough for the first down. Pump fake. Barker again. And finally gets the receiver at the 37-yard line. The catch made there by number 85, Curtis Brown.
Brown comes back for the short pass.
Well, Johnny Unitas moved there with that double pump fake. The pitch back, and they fake the reverse, and the ball is kept. Number 33, Chris Anderson, is finally dropped inside the 15. 1st and 10. The pitch back, and now they give it to Palmer this time. Barker with the block. Palmer inside the 10, down to the 6-yard line. Third down and just about an inch. Barker will get it off the left side. No problem there. 1st and goal from the 2. Anderson, touchdown. Chris Anderson's 6th rushing touchdown this year. This just ask for a valve. That's all you got to do. 1st and 10. Jamie Howard's got time to throw. Got a man open downfield. A terrific catch by Scott Ray at the 47-yard line.
Good thing there was no white jerseys around there.
1st and 10. Howard, once again, another good pass. Inside the 40, down to the 37-yard line, Torrey James, the freshman, 2nd and 9. James is the motion man on the play action, and look out. Howard is able to throw it. Oh, what a terrific job at the 22-yard line by Scott Ray. 3rd down and 3. Davis is the deep back. Howard under pressure, gets rid of it, and they got the first down. Odell Beckham. Pedro Suarez with the field goal attempt of 26 yards out of the hold of Chad Loop, and it's blocked. It's blocked.
I can tell that that was Terry London.
Antonio London is strutting like it was his deal.
They can rush 4 people and put good pressure on the quarterback and keep 7 people back in the coverage. This time they rush only 3.
Howard got his receiver, number 87, Brett Besch, makes the catch. 2nd down and 5, no timeouts remaining in this first half for LSU as Jamie Howard eludes some trouble, finally throws it over on the side, and will his receiver get out of bounds? He does. That's way short that time. Never really got any height on it. And that completes the first half of play with the 3rd-ranked Crimson Tide of Alabama leading LSU 17-5.
It's the rushing, which has put them between the goalposts, and the points on the scoreboard.
On a third down and four, they've outrushed their opponents per game, 221 yards to 59. And on the third down, the pass complete. And to the 29-yard line is Chris Anderson.
They forced Alabama into the air more than they wanted to be early on. And Barker has not been as calm as he's been in other situations.
On second and four, Anderson with the pitch. Anderson down the sideline. Anderson has got one man to beat, and he doesn't do it. First and goal from the 8-yard line, as right up the middle, driving to the goal line was Sherman Williams, and they're going to mark it just shy.
You just see the line, driving people from the line of scrimmage, giving this young sophomore a chance to run.
They give it to number 20 once again, Sherman Williams, and they signal the touchdown. And he struts his stuff. Brian DeSalle's back at his 17-yard line to punt it. It's a pretty good punt right there. Palmer at the 28. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
Trying to get people to think about this team is more than just a running attack. But further on down the road, they've got a comfortable lead at 24-5.
Blocked! The punt was blocked! Wesley Jacob fumbles it around. It's still being fumbled around. And LSU is going to come up with it. LSU has got it inside the 5 at the 3-yard line. 42, Rodney Young looked to be the man that blocked it. And then there was a battle between Wesley Jacob and one other player to try to pick it up.
Oh, Brian takes the ball easily here. One, two steps. He's getting ready to go. Oh, that's a three-step approach to the punt.
You see how high Young
was? Rodney Young gets up in the air. But he takes three steps, Roger, for the punt. He's normally a two-step punter. Gives him the extra time.
7:54 to go, third quarter. Alabama leads it 24-5. Toomer tries the right side. He's going to turn it up. That is only the 6th touchdown that Alabama has allowed this year. 24-11. Jacob in motion to the near side. Howard on the option. Didn't get it. Being through the pro wars and everything else, he enjoys the recruiting process in college football. On second down and 10, there was some movement on the line, no flag, and wide open, and across the 45, and now past midfield, is Steve Buskey. Where's that guy at? See next door. Second down. Williams wants to throw it. He's going to Palmer downfield. Broken up. Beautiful play by Carlton Buckles. Third down and 7. Alabama's 4 of 8. Third down situations. Barker pressure. He's dumped at the 46-yard line. The second sack today by LSU. And it was Bobby Williams who's really come up big. Second down and 7. Howard. Oh, looking on the right side. Gets it downfield. His tight end makes the catch. Harold Bishop. And a pickup and a first down for LSU. 6'3", 261, as Jacob goes in motion to the far side. Second and 10. They hand it up the middle. Davis has got some room. He spins across the 25 to the 28. And let's go to New York and John Saunders. John?
Drew Pearson did that once in the Dallas game.
Yeah.
Twisted in the air, came down, twisted his knee.
Exactly. Third down. And a long one. They throw it downfield and the reception made. Yes! And it counts.
Scott Ray.
You bet. Scott Ray, the junior from Baton Rouge. 5 receptions, 57 yards. First and 10 at the 33-yard line on the option. Now Howard's got a man open and he just blows it up in the air and it's going to be picked up. At the 24-yard line, George Teague, as Alabama has it 3rd and 6 at the 30-yard line. Barker blitz on, he's down. Ricardo Washington was the man that came and got him. We're set to start the final 15 minutes here. Brian DeSalle's back inside his 30 to punt it on a 4th down and 7. And
we'll get a report for you on Jamie Howard. That kick off the side of his foot, not a very good punt at all, and it's going to go out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Third down and 12.
Backside. Mike Steptoe. The fourth sack today of Jay Barker.
First and 10, 32-yard line. Plenty of time to throw, and he finds his tight end, Harold Bishop, a junior from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, if you will. Second down and 2 for LSU, 12:49 left to go in this football game. Luke to throw again, and he comes to the near side, and yeah, he made the catch on the near side over there, Brett Besch. Second down and 10. Luke, a lot of time, throwing across the field is tight end Bishop. That's a first down at the 37-yard line. First and 10 from the 39-yard line. Luke, 3 for 3 and 30 yards on the play action. And a moment. Well, he gets rid of it. No, they're going to say he was down. We're going to say he was down. Okay, yeah, spun
right
around.
On his feet, threw the touchdown pass.
Brian DeSales, the punt. And another poor punt off the side of his foot. It's a fairly good bounce. Well, it's a real good bounce. It's getting better all the time, folks. It gets down to the 16-yard line. Last time LSU beats Alabama was in Tuscaloosa in 88, 19-18. Bama's won 3 straight as the pass thrown to the far side and right on the sticks. The reception made over there by Prince Wembley. Second down and 7. Pitch back to Anderson. Good play running there. Anderson still moving. Midfield. Anderson inside the 35 to the 34-yard line, and Chris Anderson with the carry of 34 yards. Alabama has 98 more first downs this year than their opponents, and Anderson will get it trying to get another first down. Look at this. Now they're going to call him down. They're going to call him down at about the 26-yard line. Fourth down for Alabama. And that's easy. That's no problem. That's Martin Houston. All the way down to the 16-yard line. Billy Joe Hobert is suspended, so if they would want to go to their other quarterback, Grinnell's the only guy, and they've really interchanged those two this year. Alabama, 2nd and 9. Anderson one more time up the middle. Penalty marker down as Anderson gets inside the 5-yard line. Anderson has now rushed for over 150 yards today. That's a career high, but Bama is going to be called for holding.
He said, whoa, baby.
Let's go downstairs.
Let's go down.
2nd down and 19. Williams has some room. Williams. Touchdown. <laughs> 24 yards on the touchdown run.
For coming out early.
And Curry came into Alabama as a Prop 48, so even more congratulations to him, because a lot of folks said he couldn't do it, and he did it. LSU on 4th down has converted 9 of 11. And look at that, folks. Make it 10 of 12 on 4th down as the pass is completed over on the far side. 3rd down and 5. Another good catch by Scott Ray. LSU, 2nd down and 3. 1:50 left to go. Luke loses it. And covered by LSU all the way back at the 43-yard line. 3rd down and 23. Luke, not a chance. Antonio London and Jeremy Nunley, and there's a penalty marker down.
Antonio London.
And that should do it. Ellard, Chevrolet most valuable players of the game are Chris Anderson from the University of Alabama, career high 149 yards rushing today, And Bobby Williams from LSU with six tackles, four for loss. And Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. So congratulations to those two players, and congratulations to Alabama as they pick up a 31-11 victory. And we'll be back with you on the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report right after this.
Hey, number one, baby, we're coming to get you, number one. Hello, hello.
Jay Barker out of Trussville, Alabama, will open at quarterback. And at the wide receivers, they don't go deep a lot, but again, David Palmer, they will try to get his hands on the football. Up front, a workman-like offensive line led by Toby Shields. At center, a junior from Fairhope. Very smart and very quick at that position. There's Palmer on the very first play. They get him the football. Has five, has 10, has 15, and breaks it all the way out to the 50-yard line.
Good blocking up front by the offensive line. Kelvin Knight makes the tackle, number five.
And it was Prince Windley.
Against the defense. First down.
Short drop, pick out pass. He's caught for the first down, and it's Curtis Brown. Just beyond the first down marker. Needed five. He ran a six-yard pattern. Gentry making the call, and it's third down, Bama. Shovel pass to Lassick. He's got a lot of running room. At the 15, at the 10, 5, touchdown, Bama. Counter with the action, Kenny Roberts. Good heavens, no place to go. Lemanski Hall, the outside linebacker on the right, comes up and knocks him down. Lemanski Hall, by the way, you talk about speed, he's a converted strong safety, now playing at linebacker. Shovel pass, hit, knocked down, and this is going to be a loss of five more yards by Mississippi State.
Both teams have respect for each other in this kicking game.
Because of the rush last time, Jordan just, it was all he could do to get it away. But he did kick it to Palmer. Let's see if this time, if he gets time, if he will kick to him, right? They have blocked it. On the ground, and touchdown, Alabama. Antonio Langham. Option play to the near side. Turns it up. Has five. And then it's going to be picked up and driven to the turf at the 40-yard line. Well, that league continues to be more than interesting to watch. Arizona gets knocked off today after their big upset wins. Big opening in the middle for Davis. We'll take it across midfield and is down in Alabama territory for the first time tonight. As the Mississippi State coaches said, he has to play well. Again, and breaking the tackle, but this time, number two, it is Prince. 14 to nothing. Alabama on top. 5 minutes, 35 seconds left, opening quarter. Davis caught by the ankles this time by Michael Rogers. James is out. Truett is in. To the top of your screen, number 80. Play action, not going anywhere. Lemanski Hall on the blitz. Chris Gardner to attempt the field goal. This will be an attempt of 42 yards. No good. Off to the right. On third down. Short drop. Pass over the middle is complete for the first down, and it's Prince Wembley. About to go under 1 minute in this opening quarter. Little play action. Throws it complete to Lassick. He will cut it back into the middle. And all of that, and I think they picked up the first down. He's not going to make you forget Namath and a couple of other good ones they've had down there. Stabler, but he just gets it done. This is Anderson, who's coming to ball game at tailback. He'll have five, and now 10 yards in the play. This will be a 42-yard attempt. Not the distance. and he's good. That youngster having just what everybody thought, a sensational senior year. He was really unnoticed, but very good. Brown with the return again, and he'll take it back to the 40-yard line. Short drop this time. The ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage and still is caught by Truist. Tipped, and he'll have the first down at the 38-yard line.
Concentration.
Pressure straight ahead with Davis. You could see the collision as the ball is loose and Alabama has recovered. You could really see a lot of bodies flying. Tom Brown the reverse. Gets a block from his quarterback, but Woodard trying to chase him down, and he will. Mark Woodard with an outstanding defensive play. He was a tailback, injured a knee as a freshman, now as a quarterback. Anderson at the 40-yard line, out to the 42. Ball is loose, and Mississippi State has recovered. This one does not spiral at all. Palmer with the fair catch at the 11-yard line. Deal with the kick. Get a chance from the 48. Going to be hit just shy of the 35-yard line. he should be with this team. From the wishbone, they run a counter. Roberts. And he'll be down to the 20-yard line. Johnson and Shea defensively. Good pass, plenty of distance, and this time he's good. Sherman Williams comes in at tailback, number 20. Alabama thinks he's going to be the next really good one there. Rolls, has the pass, and throws it complete. Prince Wembley at the 29. Full house backfield this time. And Anderson with the first down as he takes it to the 32. Third down, and they need the 42.
Jay Barker on the drop, pressure inside, never really got a chance. Kevin Henry never gave him the opportunity to throw the football.
Deal with the kick, wobbly spiral. James will be to the 44-yard line. 28 yards in the kick, 5 on the return. Congratulations to Athletic Director Wander Offord and to head coach Billy Brewer and his staff. That'll be a Donnybrook between Ole Miss and Mississippi State this year. Straight ahead with the carry, and that's not going to be enough for the first down. They're going to say that the knee touched short of the 35-yard line. Stop and will not have it. John Copeland is the man who stuffed it. Discussing what the next plan of attack is. Sherman Wade turns the corner and look out. He will have the first down. And look for Alabama to call a quick timeout here as they have two left.
They can try to throw it downfield, deep downfield.
Looking for him over the middle. Going to go up on top though. It is tipped and caught at the 4-yard line by Lee. First and goal, Alabama. 7 seconds until halftime. So Proctor comes on to attempt the field goal. This one, 22 yards. And he knocks it home. We are at halftime. And as they head to the locker room, the Alabama Crimson Tide taking advantage of a 46-yard pass completion. It is Alabama 20, Mississippi State 3. On the carry to open the second half. The pitch to Lashick again, tries to turn the corner. He does, but not enough for the first down. Frankie Luster, you can see number 4, junior from Fort Myers, Florida. Quick pass intercepted by Mississippi State. That's Charlie Davidson, and he is inside the 10-yard line. Wants to throw it. Zings it. Tip. Pruitt. Touchdown. And Mike, as they go for 2 points, they tried to get him again when he transferred from Pitt.
Two shots at him, and he decided to go to Mississippi State on the second try.
Going to throw back with the pass, and has it complete for the 2 points. Clanton. Returnable kick by James. Return to the near sideline. One person broke the wave, and he will be stopped after a couple of yards. And that is an outstanding job defensively. Well, at the end of the game right now, he probably would be the most outstanding player. Rolls it, has a man wide open, throws it complete to Clanton, and he is inside the 30 to the 25-yard line. And roll the pocket. This time it's caught by Harris. Alabama leads. We are about to go under 11 minutes left in the ball game. Option play, and the pitch comes to McCary, and he will have the Mississippi State first down. First and 10, Mississippi State. Going to counter with a quarterback keeper. He's at the 5. He is at the 1. First and goal, Bulldogs. Alabama leading by 2, but I'm not sure they're leading in momentum right now. Pass is caught. Kevin Lee makes the reception, and that silences the crowd right there. 3 wide receivers for Alabama. Rolls the pocket, pumps it once, going to go on top, and he's got him wide open. Caught by Lee, and he drops the football. Oh, my goodness.
I'm saved on that drop.
Field to punt, and this is his best of the night. Hanging spiral at the 21-yard line. To the 40, and now to the 44. Third down. The pressure has it complete. Roberts with a first down and knocked out of bounds at the 33.
Mississippi State has to also be thinking here on third down. They're in field goal range.
Over the middle. It is caught by the tight end Clapton. Enough for the Bulldog first down. Brown the ball carrier. Randy Brown takes it to just outside the 10. James Gregory with the stop. Late substitution number 90, John Walters, comes onto the field of play for Alabama. Davis to the line. Flag goes down in the corner, and touchdown Randy Brown. Now let's check the marker, which was thrown by the referee behind the offense.
Illegal participation. Offense. Previous spot, 15 yards.
Running a distance, and he's got it. The Bulldogs go on top, 21-20. This is something they really haven't
done. Maybe a sign of impatience right now, being behind. But you still have to find a way to get the ball to number 2.
They roll the pocket, pass is thrown. Yes, they say it's a catch at the 32 to lead. Could be the final play of this third quarter. Takes it to Anderson. Drills the pass, and intercepted by Mississippi State's Charlie Davidson. Boy, that's tough news, and you see Everett Brown, number 76, who is a sophomore out of Montgomery, replacing him. Pressure from the backside, and he is going to be swamped at the 44. Eric Curry, the first man there. This is his best kick of the night. Fair catch is called for and is made at the 20-yard line by Palmer. Jay Barker, the sophomore from Trustville. Under center and a play action. He wants to put it on top. Does and has it complete. At the 38-yard line, it's Curtis Brown. It's third down. And Alabama needs the ball at the 49-yard line. Dumps off a short pass. Here's Wembley. And Prince Wembley will take it for the first down at the 45-yard line of Mississippi State. That was Daniel Boyd who hit him and knocked the football away. Third down. Play action. Barker will be hit and knocked down back at the 44. That's Stephen Henry.
Credit the Mississippi State defense.
Deal with the punt. This is James backtracking. He'll take it from the 16. It's by one. The ball is loose. Picked up by Mississippi State. And he will take it. And now fumbled. And Alabama has recovered at the 43.
He fumbled the football, Ron.
Play action. Looking for Wembley. He's got it at the 16-yard line. First and 10, Crimson Tide. Williams inside the 10, down to the 5-yard line. Barker attempting from the 17. Ball is down and he splits it. So we'll take a break. 8-10 left in the ballgame. Our new score, the Crimson Tide 23, the Bulldogs 21. Ron Franklin, Mike Gottfried, and Adrian Karsten. Wish you could be here in person. This is just, as Mike said, a good old-fashioned get down to the trenches and fight type of football here. James, no place to go, and here comes a late flag.
Pushing it back. Receiving team. Half a distance. First down.
We'll see what happens with Alabama on defense, if they change anything in this series.
Mississippi State wants to throw. Pressure is there. Gets it off, but it's complete to Roberts, and he will step out of bounds just across the 15. Here they come with the blitz. Pressure is on. Boy, they're everywhere. And the pass is intercepted by Teague at the 19-yard line. 23-21. Alabama on top. Again, they go with the running play. Anderson just a little hole, squeezes through, has the first, and it is first and goal at the 6-yard line. Straight Teague. Anderson over the top. Touchdown, Crimson Tide. Gets it away and has it complete. His tight end, Clanton, and he will be stopped at the 37. Watson Brown, what will the fourth down call be? Needs a couple. Pressure. Pass is batted down at the line of scrimmage, and it's Everett Brown who got a big hand up, replacing James Gregory, who knocked down the fourth down attempt. This is, guys, in case you have to go back in the lineup, Martin Houston with a rare carry, and he will take it down inside the 35-yard line. It on the ground, and that will be enough for the Alabama first down just inside the 30-yard line.
Alabama 7-0, they'll go to 10-0. Mississippi State will be 4-3, and this means that they clinch the West,
and they are in that championship game on the 5th. Let's take a quick look over at the East. Georgia 6-2, 8-2, Florida at 5-2, but Florida clinches the title with a win against Vandy next week because of their win over Georgia earlier. Well, the longest winning streak that Alabama's ever had was 28, and Mississippi State broke that back in 1980. Had a chance to repeat history, but it's not going to be true tonight as Palmer takes the pitch and is down at the 21-yard line. Minute 17 seconds left as State will take over the ball. Pass is caught by Truett, and he will be pushed out of bounds out at the 34-yard line by Chris Donnelly. How quickly they can get rid of this one, because Ole Miss is a very good football team who secured a Liberty Bowl berth today. That ball is caught inside the 40. Pass is thrown complete. Willie Harris, and he will go out of bounds. Pass is tipped, and it's caught at the 11-yard line. Pressure from the outside. Pumps once. Now in the end zone, ball is tipped, and George Teague comes up with the interception, and that will do it with 28 ticks left on the clock.
Now, Ron, before this game ends, as you look at Watson Brown frustrated, Johnny Majors, of course, we all know the news at Tennessee. He went 16 years. He took Tennessee to 12 bowl games. Last 3 years in January 1st bowls. Last 6 years, he won 3 SEC champions. I don't understand it.
So now, the Alabama Crimson Tide in the championship game, the first ever SEC championship game as a two-division race.
Brian Karkowska kicking off for the Tigers. One of the most exciting players in college football. One of the deep men, David Palmer. Going to let him show his stuff right away. Palmer to the 10. Palmer, stutter step, short of the 20-yard line and down. And we see that there is a penalty flag on the kickoff. An illegal block against Alabama on the return. Barker tosses to Lassick. Huge hole to the 14, and Chris Schelling makes the stop. Second and 3 after the 7-yard run by Lassick, and Lassick the lone running back. Now the toss to Palmer, who comes around on the reverse, a familiar play for Tide fans, to the 18-yard line. Prince Wembley, isn't that a wonderful name? He's down there to Barker's left, having just checked in. This is Houston, the fullback, smashing straight ahead to the 32-yard line. Alabama on the roll, first and 10. First and 10 for Bama at their own 32-yard line. This the initial drive. Barker's first pass of the day. He's going to keep it. A big hole. Barker for a first down. Deal back to punt with Thomas Bailey, the wide receiver. Standing at the Auburn 15, he'll field this at the 16-yard line. Dances and smacked down short of the 20. Good coverage by Alabama. Daniel wants a walk-on punter at Alabama before moving to Auburn. His first punt of the game, and it's a beauty.
It's a little bit low, though, Brett. He's outkicked the coverage.
Palmer jitterbugs, and he's down at the 30-yard line. Curtis Brown brings the play in from the Alabama sideline. Lassick tossed to the left. On, cuts back, and finally explodes to the 41-yard line. And a Bama first down. But this is a long five. Palmer steps in motion, and Barker off the blitz with that inside pitch to Lassick. And Lassick is not going to get the first down. Good defense by Auburn.
That's a number one.
At the 19.
Excellent coverage.
There was one span during his 12-year career at Auburn that he defeated Alabama 4 consecutive times. Now Barker, back for Alabama. Gets it into the hands of a lineman, and that's an illegal.
No way.
Oh, my Bears punt. Bailey to the 24. Bailey to the 31-yard line. From the shotgun again. White drops it into Bostic's hands. Bostic to the 46-yard line and an Auburn first down.
Get rid of the ball before the rush gets there.
Reed McMillan in at running back for Auburn. He's protecting for White.
Pass,
drops it incomplete, and there's the penalty flag.
First down, spot of foul.
Palmer standing at the Alabama 12. This one angling toward the sideline. Now it'll ricochet toward the end zone. It's a touchback. It'll come out on the 20-yard line.
Taking a look at the numbers, you can see what we're talking about. 91 yards of total offense generated between the two teams. No turnovers yet. Time and possession, just 1 minute in favor of Alabama. Not much going on so far.
I think I said it was first down as we started the quarter. Actually, it was second down. So this is third down. Barker, Lasik flaring, fires toward Palmer, caught it, and smashed by Willis. Deal, busy man from Alabama, punting again.
Lousy punt.
Bailey on one hop is hammered and down at the 37-yard line.
Here's that unbalanced line.
Bostic found a crease that time. And up to the 48-yard line. Bostic follows it to that side. Across midfield. And Bostic finding success to the 43-yard line. There were a couple of excellent catches against them by the Mississippi State athletes. But those youngsters opened some holes in this Vonnegut defense. Now White off a fake. And doesn't buy enough time as Elvis Brown closes in with Copeland. And White, under pressure against the blitz, throws, intercepted by Johnson. 15-20. The first turnover of the game, down at the 27-yard line.
But I guess I'm a little surprised on third and one, when Lasik has been able to pick up a yard, that they would throw the ball. They're 0 for 5 on third down in this game. And there's the punt with the fair catch at the 30-yard line.
Using the double tight end formation against this fierce rush. Just absolutely no time for McMillan. Michael Rogers crawled all over him. White will operate from the shotgun. And here comes the rush. Curry takes him down at the 12-yard line. Here's an opportunity for Alabama. Daniel standing just inside the goal line, and Palmer could give him excellent field position. Doesn't have to.
Here his team involved in a scoreless tie with Pat Dye's team. Lasik is cut off by the Auburn defense. An unwise decision on the young man's part. Takes a huge loss. Out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
Second and 26 for Barker in Alabama.
Barker with time. Intercepted by Anthony Harris. Alabama shows blitz, backs off, still get pressure. Here's Parker. Fumble. Alabama at midfield has recovered.
Him.
Wow. Hit on the release, and Palmer makes a diving reception at the 26.
Derek Lasik carrying the bulk of the load in the first half, but now Williams and Barker off a quick drop, looking back to the right, and Palmer and incomplete because of Calvin Jackson, and there's a penalty flag down. Interference is called against Jackson. Barker intercepted in the end zone by Smith. So Alabama turns it over for the second time.
Third and five. White
out of the shotgun. London in pursuit. Throws complete to the 32-yard line. He may run right out of his right shoe. At the 13. Penalty. Tackled at the 23-yard line.
Got an illegal push in the back. 10-yard penalty. Spot a foul on the run back.
Second down and 10 now. Wham Lassick trying to break free from Willis. Was he down or not? Apparently, he was not. There's the delay. Fullback Houston. Oh, at the 13-yard line. Cunningham and Smith. So we've got a late hit against Auburn. Last play of the first half, and it's a big run for Alabama.
Saturday. Renting apartments, applying for jobs. Prime time.
Parker, and the first half comes to an end on that completed pass to Curtis Brown. Pat Dye's last game, and his Auburn Tigers are scoreless with Alabama. Driven out of bounds near the 25-yard line, where it will be first and 10 for Stan White and the Auburn Tigers. Bostic the tailback.
Unbalanced line.
Bostic, left side, still plowing to the 34-yard line. Second and one. Reed McMillan checking in for Auburn. Gets the call, battles for the first down to the 38-yard line. White off a play fake, has time, hits Bailey, first down Auburn inside the Alabama 45-yard line. Carter, the wide receiver, replacing Bailey. Bostic, whole right side, inside the 40-yard line to the Bama 39. Parker and Bailey are off to the left of the quarterback. Bostic, the running back, off a fake. White looks left, high, intercepted! It off, and he's going to go the distance. Antonio Langham. Now with 16, leading the SEC. Bostic off a fake. White. Receivers are covered, and White takes it out of bounds at the 25-yard line, second and five. Bostic, on the second effort, gives Auburn a first down. Fake to Bostic on the hurry move. He's down at the 21-yard line. Pat Dye announcing his resignation last night. His team trailing Alabama. Bama with a chance to win a national championship. Getting a scare from Auburn here today. After the penalty, Palmer fields this one on the 40. And he is hit immediately and down. Blitz. Barker against it. He hits his running back, Lassick, who slipped out. Lassick to the 35-yard line, and a Bama first down. Houston to the 29-yard line.
They're coming with a blitz.
Ooh, and against it, just using Martin Houston. Barker under pressure. Down at the 30-yard line for Michael Proctor with the 47-yard field goal attempt. Proctor puts Alabama up by 10. Daniel punting. Off the side of his foot. Goes out of bounds, short of midfield. Jay Barker. And he hands off to his tailback, who makes it to the 40-yard line. Chris Anderson. Right now it is Alabama with a second and 4. And the defense ruled on that play. It was Chucky Johnson hitting first with a penalty flag coming down. Face mask against Auburn.
5-yard penalty.
The toss. It's Williams. Big hole on the right side. He's close to another Bama first down. Houston barges for a Bama first down. First down on the Auburn 24-yard line. Williams on a beautiful cutback. Smith and Schelling there defensively for the Tigers.
They'd love to have their first one to recover.
Fair catch at the 34, but a penalty flag down back by the line of scrimmage.
We have holding on the receiving team. It'll be 10 yards post-scrimmage kick foul. 10 yards, should be first down red.
Yeah, gentlemen, his name is Algernon Banks. It was discovered that he has terminal cancer, and his inspiration has been this University of Alabama football team, and earlier today, he did get to meet with the cheerleaders and the coaching staff, and it was a very touching and poignant moment for all involved.
And a lot of players like Bo Jackson will tell you they enjoyed playing for Pat Dye. They thought he was an outstanding person. Isaac?
You know, Brent, I think we've got to some way come up with a way of defining the difference between helping a kid and cheating.
We don't have the blimp with us today, but maybe we can get him to take a camera.
They're coming after him again, Brent.
Williams down.
I think they fumbled it.
Anthony Harris may have gotten a hand on that ball. Yes, he gave Auburn a life. Then on Saturday, we'll be down in Tallahassee, Florida, Florida State.
That one's at noon.
Here it is, complete to Carter. And Carter to the 35-yard line. Fourth down, White throws, first down. He hits Frank Sanders, and a penalty flag coming down.
We have a dead ball, personal foul, the offensive team. Oh,
that's dumb.
It'll be a first foul and 25.
That's too bad.
First down. Right. Hit on the release and caught at the 30-yard line with a diving reception, and White is lucky to get it off, and Bailey makes the catch. They're going to need 3 scores here in the last 5 minutes to get anything done. This is a 48-yarder.
Looks short.
They still need 3 scores. Because it ran for about a half minute. There's the fullback, Martin Houston, lumbering up for a few more yards against Auburn.
Auburn might as well put 9 or 10 guys right up in there and try to go in there and strip it.
The serenade for Pat Dye, the Alabama faithful. First down to midfield as Martin Houston. Florida, Florida State, and that'll be on the air at 12 noon on ABC. then later at night, Notre Dame and USC at 8 Eastern time. Here it is over.
Hey, you're doing it right.